Kullervo is not the most well-known figure in Kalevala. This might be because his story is slightly separated from the Kalevala. You could even say a spin-off. However, his story has inspired many writers, including J.R.R. Tolkien. The story of Kullervo begins when his father Kalervo gets into argument with his brother Untamo. It turns out that Untamo was the wrong guy to argue with, as he came with his troops and killed everyone from the Kalervo's family, except one girl who was made a slave for Untamo. That girl gave birth to Kullervo. Untamo had no intentions to keep his enemy's son as dependent, so he tried to kill him.
Destroy the child.
But this turned out to be harder than one could imagine, as Kullervo was not an ordinary child. For example, they threw Kullervo into the water hoping that he would drown. But the boy survived. So, Untamo decided that Kullervo could live, but he would have to work for his living. Unfortunately, Kullervo was completely useless as a worker. And because of that, Untamo decided to pass him forward and sold him to Ilmarinen. Ilmarinen sent Kullervo to herd cattle. Ilmarinen's wife, being a nice lady, made a bread for Kullervo, so he had something to eat while herding. But it turned out the bread was a trap. And the nice lady turned out to be a total bitch, as she had baked a stone into the bread. Kullervo broke his knife because of that stone. And he was quite upset, because that knife was the sole memento he had from his father. In fact, he was so upset that he drove the cattle into a swamp and enchanted the beast of the forest to look like cows and herd them to the house of Ilmarinen, where they killed his wife.
Goodbye, bitch!
Now that Kullervo had a little taste of revenge, he decided that maybe he should have some more. And thus, he headed to the house of Untamo, where he could get more of that sweet, sweet revenge. But on the way to the Untamo's house, he got the news that his family was still alive, so he decided to pause his quest for revenge. His family was indeed still alive, and only his sister was gone missing and was presumably dead. Kullervo's father quickly noted the same thing as Untamo, which was that Kullervo was completely useless when it came to manual labor. He then got an idea how he could make his son useful and sent him to collect taxes. While collecting taxes, Kullervo decided that he needed a woman into his life, so he tried to pick one up.
It's make out time!
But it turned out that Kullervo was a really bad pickup artist, and all the women turned him down. He then came across this poor girl, who also turned him down at first, but when Kullervo showed her the wealth he had collected, she quickly changed her mind. This tactic was indeed so successful that Kullervo speedran through all the bases directly to the home base.
If you catch my meaning.
Life was finally turning around for Kullervo, or so he thought, until he found out that this girl was actually his lost sister.
What a twist!
Now, people will react differently to this kind of news. Those who are like Jaime Lannister can react something like this.
A surprise, to be sure, but a welcome one.
But the majority of the people won't have so positive reaction. Unfortunately, Kullervo's sister belonged to the latter group. After this incident, Kullervo decided that now is a good time to continue his quest for revenge against his uncle. His mother tried to stop him, but she couldn't change his mind. Unfortunately for his uncle, Kullervo was successful in his revenge, and he kills the entire clan of Untamoinen. But when he returned home, he noticed that all his family was gone for good. Kullervo ends up having a little chat with his sword, and after that, he takes his own life by falling down on his own sword. The moral of the Kullervo story could be the following. Don't let revenge consume you, and before getting romantically involved with someone, do a little background check. For example, you can ask the question, who's your daddy? And if you have the same answer, you should reconsider the situation.
Nainen! Tarkoittaako tämä nyt, että me harrastamme seksiä?
Siis vittun idiootti, mä oon sun sisko!
Aha, noutatko edes suihin?